This video is purely made for educational and harm reduction purposes and does not promote the use of drugs.
If you're the average person, you're probably doing nitrous wrong, or at least inefficiently. Now, despite what the propaganda and the misinformed say, nitrous oxide is actually a very safe drug that, if used correctly, isn't going to cause you much damage and can have profound benefits. That doesn't mean I condone the use of it though.
Because drugs are bad, okay? It's a bad thing to do drugs, so don't be bad.
It does have very real risks, which I'll get to in a little bit. Unfortunately, even if you're wise enough to do the research on how to do nitrous, you'll get various methods and loads of misinformation, so today we're going to clear all of that up. I'm not going to talk about dispensers, I'll potentially save that for a future video as I don't have experience with them yet, though the method's still the same if you're using balloons. Now onto the fun topic, we've got to talk about the dangers. Numero uno, there's a difference between medical grade nitrous and food grade nitrous. Be aware that you're not just taking in pure gas, but also all of the impurities in it. Of course, with the war on drugs, it's hard to access medical grade nitrous, so I wouldn't do this often as it's not going to be good for your body if it's a regular thing. Number two, abusing nitrous can cause a vitamin B12 deficiency. If you're vegan, this is especially bad as vitamin B12 only really comes in animal products. You want to be supplementing methylcobalamin B12. Don't judge me, I'm not quite shogun. This is really important. Not all B12 supplements are gonna help. You want that specific kind. It's water soluble, so you can't really overdose on it, and I recommend you take some before doing nitrous, though if you're really abusing it, this might not save you. There just isn't enough time to go over all the conflicting studies. Unlike the nitrous dimension, time is pretty linear here, so if you're taking nitrous often, you should go do a lot of reading yourself. Number 3. Sorry, I spent like a decade learning French and I have to flex it somehow. This links with the first two problems, and it's that nitrous is quite addictive. If you're prone to addictions, I would sort that out before even trying this. Once you do one, it's very likely you'll want more, especially if you can still feel it, and since it's so easy to get, especially if you really like making whipped cream, you're probably gonna end up doing more than you need to. When I first tried nitrous, I definitely abused it a little before I realized where that was leading me and I stopped. Don't just think it won't happen to you. Many people have ruined their lives with this drug, and we don't need more statistics to fuel the war on drugs. Be responsible. Finally, number 4, do this somewhere safe. I really can't stress this enough. Don't do it standing up, especially if you're drunk. Sit down and be prepared to potentially go unconscious. Ideally, you'd be somewhere cushiony. I did nitrous on a stool once and I still fell backwards. I don't expect you to wear a helmet, but don't be stupid and minimize risk as much as possible. If you can't sit down, just don't do it. So you've got your 8-gram chargers, you've got a cracker, and you've got a balloon. I recommend you get one of those crackers with a rubber grip. The cracker will get very cold, and if you don't have a rubber grip, then you need gloves or use your shirt or something. It's very easy. Put the balloon on the cracker. Do not inhale directly from the cracker. Don't even think about it. There's a decent chance you'll die. There's no safe way to do it, just don't. Now you want to twist the cracker, which will pierce the canister, and then twist it back again, and the balloon will start to fill up. If you want 2 chargers and 1 balloon, just hold the tip and reload. Be careful though, as this might cause your balloon to pop. If you're doing multiple balloons, then the cracker will get very cold, so watch out. So now you've got a balloon nicely filled with nitrous, how do you take it in the safest, most efficient way possible? I've done nitrous hundreds of times using all the different methods. Here's the best one I found. Take a breath from the balloon and then breathe in normal air, as you would when smoking. You can keep breathing in until your lungs are mostly full. Some people hold in the hits without taking a breath, but the problem with this is you're not getting oxygen, and if you're mixing with other substances, especially psychedelics, you might forget you're holding your breath. This has happened to me a few times, and it was not very fun to be going for an ego death with no oxygen. If you like, you can hold your breath a little bit as long as you breathed in oxygen after your nitrous hit, though if you're tripping, I still don't recommend it. In my experience, this doesn't make the nitrous any less intense, and it means you're not depriving yourself of oxygen. You can blow out, take another hit, and then take another hit of air, and then blow out, take another hit, until the balloon is finished. The most common mistake, and what you don't want to do, is blow in and out of the balloon. You're literally breathing in your own carbon dioxide, and there's really no point. You're better off just holding the hit in. The nitrous also spends less time in your lungs, so even though you might get some recycled nitrous in you, in my experience, it's still not as intense as just breathing in a hit and then adding air with it, as that way, the nitrous spends much longer in your lungs. Also, with this method, you'll probably lose a sense of time and breathe in and out for too little or too long, which is going to give you inconsistent effects. If you want to be even safer, take some quick clean breaths of air in between nitrous hits. I do this when I'm doing nitrous more than a couple of times or if I'm doing a double balloon. If you want to amplify the effects, you can take smaller hits of nitrous at a time and breathe in more air instead. This essentially just means that the nitrous spends more time in your lungs and it will also extend the experience a little bit. Personally, I stay within 3 to 4 hits from each charger. If you do less, you can probably expect a less intense experience unless you're holding your breath for quite a long time. If you do more, it can get more intense to an extent, but the peaks of each hit might not line up anymore, and you'll get a longer, less intense experience. Notice how this method means that if anything, you're getting more oxygen than if you just breathe normally, and you're also getting the nitrous. It might not be the most intense method, but it's close, and if you're really desperate for more intensity, then just take more. Why would you sacrifice your health when there's really no need? It also feels a lot cleaner and you get the effects without that dirty feeling that you're damaging your body. I always recommend waiting a few minutes between each balloon. You want to give yourself a little break, which I know can be hard when you're coming down and you want to go back to that place where everything made sense, but trust me, it's not worth it in the long run. I hope this video helped you out. I've got future nitrous related videos coming out, so subscribe if you want more of those and feel free to support the channel for our Patreon. Have a good trip, especially if you're mixing it with psychedelics, and I'll catch you all next week.